As of November 24th of 2024, there are currently 48 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 2 more than were erupting last week. Of these, the volcano with the longest continuously ongoing eruption is Vanuatu's Yasur volcano, erupting for approximately 800 years straight at a low to moderate intensity via both primarily Strombolian and Vulcanian eruptions. This prolonged activity has all occurred from its ever-growing cinder cone, which in that time span has reached a prominence of 306 meters or 1,004 feet. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Japan, an unexpected earthquake swarm struck a volcano with a record of large explosive eruptions that has not erupted since the early 10th century. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, the Dempo volcano produced an unexpected eruption via a powerful explosion, sending fragments of rock as high as 720 meters or 2,362 feet into the air. But this week's top story involves a new eruption of Iceland's Reykjanes volcano due to both the damage it caused and how large of a lava field it rapidly created. This latest eruption began at the Reykjanes volcano on Iceland's peninsula, which bears the same name, at 11:14 p.m. local time on November 20th, initially generating sustained lava fountains with heights of 40 meters or 131 feet along an expanding fissure. This fissure would grow to become 2,605 meters long. However, from the get-go, something was clearly off. Unlike the 6 preceding eruptions during 2024, this eruption was not visibly larger than its prior eruption, seemingly involving only 1/3 of the magma it would have contained if it had instead erupted a bit later during the first week of 2025. However, this amount, equating to an estimated 32 million cubic meters of magma, was still sufficient to create a river of lava directed towards the west. This molten rock quickly flowed onto 2 major paved roads, causing the bitumen on these to ignite and produce a black plume. Thankfully, lava continued north and west outside of the 9-meter or 29.5-foot high rock and dirt berms that protected both the Blue Lagoon and the Svartsengi geothermal power plant, which were continually maintained by the hard work of construction crews. However, a singular building and the main parking lot of the Blue Lagoon were outside of this berm, and as a result were soon covered in a layer of lava. Heading over to Japan, 30 kilometers west-southwest of a city that goes by the same name, we have the massive lake-filled caldera of the Towada volcano. This massive caldera, which outsizes Oregon's famous crater Lake Caldera, formed during a series of at least 4 ultra-Plinian eruptions between 61,000 and 14,000 years ago. During the Holocene, its eruptions have continued to be infrequent, but very large when they do occur, with all 8 of its Holocene eruptions reading on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as a 4 or 5. Thus, when unrest occurs at this volcano, scientists take notice, as the odds are when the next eruption occurs, it will be similarly large to some of its prior Holocene eruptions, the last of which occurred in the year 915. Well, the most significant form of unrest to strike the Towada volcano in more than a century occurred on November 22nd, when more than 70 earthquakes occurred largely beneath the southern portion of the inner 3-kilometer-wide Nakanumi caldera, which is where all 8 of its Holocene eruptions occurred. These quakes were clearly volcanic in origin, but no ground deformation or unusual gas emissions were detected alongside them, so the alert level of the Towada volcano remained at its normal level. And in Indonesia, after experiencing a series of earthquake swarms in recent months, the Dempo volcano on the island of Sumatra produced a large explosion and thus a new eruption from its crater lake at 1:09 p.m. local time on November 23rd. This sent a plume of rock, gases, and ash to a height of 720 meters above its acidic crater lake via what is known as a phreatic eruption. Thankfully, no one was harmed, but this 4-minute-long eruption, which likely registered on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as a 1, represented this volcano's largest eruption since 2022. This could very well be a one-off eruption, or it could erupt multiple times again during the next several days to weeks. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on November 23rd of 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member Gam for supporting my work.